Number one, it gives us persuasion and it gives us proof that what God has said and is saying is true. Number one, true. Number two, dependable. And it shall come to pass. So we have persuasion and proof that God is on your side and He will see you through. He says in the opening of that particular passage that we read, but beloved, when he looked at that, he put but, then put a comma, and then put beloved. Wanted us to understand the importance of what went on before verse number 9 to help us that we are better persuaded of things concerning you. But beloved, you are loved of God. Even when nobody else don't want to show the love, you are still loved of God. People can give you a new suit, a new dress. They can give you all types of money and still not love you. But the Lord said, but you are loved. You are greatly loved by God. Because you are the servant of the Most High God. Even when the saints don't get with you, you still know you got more on your side. Because the right before you is more than the world that is against you. He says, I am persuaded of better things of you. Things that come from this what we went through. Because there were some that didn't stand. They fell away. For those who fell away, he said it's kind of hard for them to be restored. Because what they've done, they crucified Christ afresh. Those who put him to open shame. But you withstood, and you're still withstanding. And you don't give in to false doctrine. And you don't give in to apostasy. You still know there's one Lord. There is one faith. And there is one baptism. You still know without a doubt that his name is Jesus. For she shall bring forth a son. Jesus, and this Jesus shall save his people from their sin. Even when the saints, some of them come to a place where they want to deliberate and dispute the doctrine of God, you still stand and say, Jesus' name is right, and the Holy Ghost with the evidence of speaking with tongues is right. Stand for the truth, because the truth will make you free. He's a handsome help in this world. But thank you for thy word, for your word is forever settled in heaven. I wish I had somebody just to give God.
Hallelujah!
So he says, we are persuaded of things which accompany salvation. When you receive the Holy Ghost, that's not all you get. Because there's something that goes along with it. Something that belongs to salvation. Now, we read that scripture and some of y'all said, what is he talking about? That scripture said there are many things that accompany salvation. You are saved to be saved. You were saved. You are being saved. You shall be saved. And you are saved by grace. Sufficient. My strength is made perfect in your weakness. Thank God for grace. Oh, to salvation, we have a blessed hope. That blessed hope for those who work and labor in the Lord, they shall be rewarded. The things that accompany salvation is that they have also a great catching away of the saints. For the Lord will snatch us away. We shall be caught up to meet Him and them in there. And so shall we ever, ever be with the Lord. Well, you want me to close, and I do too. Looking at this, God is not unrighteous to forget your work and labor of love. For God is not like man. Man soon forget. Come on, somebody. And man is so unrighteous that he wouldn't give you credit for whatever you've done. You can help them along the way, more ways than spiritual. They will still not give you the credit. But thank God that God sees what you have done when others don't see what you have done. Thank God that you don't have to have a trumpet to say, look what I've done. Well, the Lord knows. Come on, somebody. The Lord knows that He is not unrighteous to forgive your labor, your work and labor of love. Well, Lord, I thank you. God will repay. Your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Because if that's the case, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For your labor is not in vain in the Lord. I like the way he put it in the Corinthians 15 and 58. Your work and your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Picked up revised from that from Hebrews. Work and labor. Motive for your work is that you have to have a love. Come on, somebody. You have to have a love towards His name. Come on, somebody. But Jesus told Peter that if you love me, you will feed my lambs. If you love me, you will feed my sheep. If you love me, you will feed my sheep. He did that three times. First time, lambs. Second time, sheep. Third time, sheep. Said, if you really love me, you will feed my people. Give to those lambs that need to become sheep to help them along life's way. Now, Lord, thank you. 1 Thessalonians chapter number 1, verse number 3 says, for your work and your labor of faith and patience and labor of love shall not be unnoticed, because God knows what you're going through. Love what makes labor and work so delightful. Come on, somebody. It is because you love God that His yoke is easy and His burden is light. It's because you love God that you come to the conclusion, I delight to do Thy will. Even though it's strained, even though it's difficult, even though it's kind of hard to get through. But oh God, I remember your word, who for the joy despised the shame and ran and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. You are a good God. Thank you. Keep on looking up. Keep on being encouraged. Come on, stand with me for just a minute. Come on up here. Keep on going. No matter what you're going through, if you're ostracized and criticized, make up in your mind, I'll press my way. For God Almighty, be good to me. He set me free. Keep on going. Stay in the press. Make up your mind. I've got to work and labor till my day is done. And remember this, someday morning, when your life is over, you will fly away to be at rest with the Almighty God. Well, thank you. Come on, somebody, give God thanks. Now we all stand.